And our team coverage of Edmund Zagorski's execution continues with our Brandon Marshall in the 5 Alert Center. Brandon, I know you talked with several protesters outside before the execution. What did they have to say?
Rory, one man at tonight's protest who visited the death row inmate in prison said the convicted killer told him this week he was, quote, at peace and ready to go. Edmund Zagorski, before he was electrocuted, nearly 60 people against the death penalty gathered in a circle holding candles outside the Riverbend facility. They prayed for the two men he killed back in 1983, John Dotson and Jimmy Porter, and for all the victims of violence. A priest I spoke with says Tennessee and our nation need to work to abolish the death penalty.
This is being done in our names. The ball is in our court. We are the ones who are making the decision to take a human life.
There were only two men for the death penalty at tonight's protest. One man told those praying, quote, we're going to kill your boy tonight. He also said he understands Zagorski says he's sorry for what he did years ago, but that does not make it right.
What got him on death row was he slit their throats. In my opinion, if he wouldn't have done that part, he'd already be out of prison. But he turned a robbery into a heinous crime.
Now the next scheduled execution in Tennessee will be later this month. Cedric Clayton will be put to death. He shot his girlfriend and both of her parents in Memphis back in 2014. We're at the 5 Alert Center tonight. Brandon Marshall, News Channel 5.
Brandon, thanks. A recap now of what happened this evening. Just before 7 p.m., the Supreme Court denied a stay of execution for Zagorski. The first jolt of electrocution happened at 7:16 p.m. Another jolt was given minutes later. Edmund Zagorski was pronounced dead at 7:26 p.m.